Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. A while ago, I did a tutorial showing how to create rain text. Now, I'll show you a variation of that theme by creating an image of a recognizable view looking outside a rainy, foggy window pane. I provided this raindrops image so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, open a photo you'd like to use for the view outside the window. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. To place your photo into the raindrop document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the raindrops. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto the raindrops and release. Pressing Shift kept your image centered over the document. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you want to move it up or down, press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Then, press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the lock icon to unlock the background. Drag the raindrops layer above your photo. If you look closely at the raindrops image, you'll notice there's a lot of noise or grain in the photo. To minimize this, go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. I'll enlarge the preview so we can see the difference after we reduce the noise. Click the Detail icon, and under Noise Reduction, slide the luminance all the way to the right. Then press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to Screen. To adjust the overall image's brightness and contrast, click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. I'll drag the brightness down to -70. And the contrast up all the way to 100. Since each photo has its own unique characteristics, feel free to play with these amounts. Click the Adjustment Layer icon again, and this time click Vibrance. I'll slide it to -30, and the saturation to +34. But again, you may want to use different amounts. Make Layer 1 active and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Let's name the copy Blurred and the original Zigzag. Make the Blurred layer active and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 10 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Hide the blurred layer so we can see the layer under it. Make the zigzag layer active and go to Filter, Distort, and Zigzag. Make the style around center and the amount 2 and the ridges 2. This gives our image just enough distortion that a glass pane may give to it. Then, click OK. Make the blurred layer visible again and make it active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the brush size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity 70%. Then press Enter or Return. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Start with approximately this size and brush over your image. Feel free to make your brush smaller as well. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.